Hi guys, here is a quick tutorial how to create Rasengan from Naruto in VFX graph in Unity.
Okay, so that's the starting project we have for high definition render pipeline. And so you can see everything. That's a starting scene. I'm not gonna use it, so we'll go and open the and create a new HD template scene. That was the one I was using. So as you can see, it's almost the same as the one I have. So next thing you should do is to check if your package manager, if your packages are up to date, and especially high definition render pipeline. It's loading, and you can filter for those that are in project, and you can update it. So here we have some samples that you can download as well. We don't need it right now. So we have the basic scene, basic HD sample scene. And the first thing you need to do is to create visual FX graph, and you do it right here. I'm still searching for it since it's new stuff. So let's call it Rasengan. Alright, and you just drag and drop it here, and as you can see, something is going on. So let's edit it, and that's the basic graph we have. Maybe we can place it somewhere visible. Yeah, let's change this. And inspector here, since it will be not useful, not so much. And first thing you have to do is to remove those, and basically right click, read node, system, and use simple swarm particle system. And you should have the simple swarm particle system if you uncheck the lightning. And that was the first thing I couldn't pass by. But all you have to do is to select the quad output and check use exposure weight. And then change the weight here, and it will be right there, as you can see. So it's basically how much it is infected in the standard render setting for exposure. So we have like post-processing stack here, and it's like it's having basic settings that are very high for the global illumination and stuff. I didn't go deep into it. It's just working, so I'm doing it like that. Maybe it's later important when you want the particles to light a fog or stuff like that. But for a Rasengan, that's enough. So next thing we have to do, and that effect is pretty cool. But I was thinking maybe it took me less than 45 minutes, but I need to do something mine. Actually, with this, so the VFX graph has few parts. I will not go deep into it since that's not the part of this tutorial. We'll go for the Rasengan. So let's go. First thing, we'll need to add an update. Press space, select update, press space, and add force. Add conform to sphere. So that's actually how you make the particles stick in your sphere. And next thing you need to do to have a Rasengan is to change its colors. So I have few predefined AGRR presets, but you can also play with it a little bit more. Now, as you can see, when we change the exposure weight, it's basically changing how bright the Rasengan is. But of course, you can go here and change the color intensity. So it's changing how much light those emit, those particles are emitting. And what's cool here is that we have a color over life. So the farther this way, the older particles are. And you can see it actually. Maybe it's even not visible in this Rasengan, but if you would use some kind of really simple gradient, we would have a way better. Maybe those colors are close, or our particles are dying before that, because we have, now you can see we are getting some green particles, and it depends how old they are, they are getting the color on the right side. So for the lifetime, we have a random lifetime from 1 to 3. And, basically that's all for the Rasengan. So I did it in 45 minutes, but I was learning. And now, as I told you, it's a really simple effect. So basically this comfort sphere is doing everything. And for something more that you can do is to add variables that will be visible in the inspector. So first one I would use will be the gradient. So let's call it gradient, drag and drop it here and put it here. So now you can choose the default value and check exposed. So when we choose Rasengan, we'll have here a gradient, and you can now do like multiple different Rasengans out of the box. Let's make them a little bit brighter, and that's cool. Another thing is that we could actually control how many particles are spawned, and we create new int. Let's call it rate or spawn rate. I think 25,000 is really a lot. So 3,000 for the starting value and connect. Or maybe more would be good. Like since those particles are pretty small. Yeah. So we have few Rasengans here. Not so difficult as you could thought it is. Another thing I was doing is actually changing the vector field force or the starting position sphere radius. So that gives you, I think it was this one. Yeah, that gives you a little bit more crazy particles here that are trying to run away from or run into. As you can see, this conform sphere. And then you can also change traction speed that the Rasengan is gaining, or the force. Oh, that this one is actually not doing much. We can have less There's a lot of things you can play with, but that's not a part of this tutorial. So the last one that I did is adding a light source inside. So let's Control Z from these crazy particles, and I basically added simple point light right inside my Rasengan. So let's drag it here. Sorry, it wasn't point light, it was sphere. Yeah, it was sphere, and I've created a material for it. Let's go Rasengan core, add it on sphere, then we need to adjust its emission parameters so it will be emitting anything. So it depends how bright you want it to be, and now make it a little bit smaller. Okay, something like that. You can add this one into the other Rasengan we have. Reset its position a little smaller. And you have like two awesome looking Rasengans ready to play with. So you can do a lot of different stuff. Here as well as my Rasen Shuriken, you probably so different pose. So it was basically the main Rasengan here, and then I was adding four particle systems around, and one that was conformed to circle, and then animation and rotation that was done in standard Unity tools. So that's it. I hope you like it. It was my first tutorial. If you like it, let me know and let me know what you didn't like. So that would be cool. Thank you. Thanks, guys, and have a nice time with VFX Graph. Bye.